Let's begin with the vertical line test. The vertical line test can be used to determine whether a graph represents a function. If we can draw any vertical line that intersects a graph in more than one place, then the graph does not define a function because a function has only one output value for each input value. Let's see what I mean by this. For example, in which of the following graphs is y a function of x? So looking at that first graph, if I draw a vertical line right here, and again, this said drawing any vertical line, you can see this graph intersects, or this line intersects the graph in three different places. So since it intersected it at more than one place, we are able to say that this is not a function. But the question is why? Why does that work? Well, when we draw a vertical line, essentially what you're doing is you're going through that specific x value, so x equals 2. So each of these points on the graph have an x value of 2. So that means for that one input value, there's 1, 2, 3 different output values. In order to be a function, you can only have one different output value. If I looked here and drew my vertical line through x equals 0, you can see for x equals 0, it goes to three different y values. So that's why this vertical line test works. If I look at the second one, this is a function. And that's because if I draw a vertical line anywhere, I'm only going to intersect this graph in at most one place. And the second one is, or the third one, is not a function. Here, if I draw a vertical line in lots of different places on this graph, it's going to intersect it in more than one place. The zeros of a function. The zeros of a function, f, are the solutions to the equation f of x equals 0. So in other words, they're all of the x values that make the equation equal 0, or all of the x values that have a corresponding y value of 0. The function p is graphed to the right. Determine the following. The zeros of p. So again, I'm figuring out what x values have a y value of 0. Well, y is going to equal 0 on the x-axis. So that means that the zeros are actually the x-intercepts. So this value here, when x equals negative 3, has a y value of 0. And this value here, when x is 3, has a y value of 0. So the zeros of p are negative 3 and 3. State the domain of p. So domain are all of the possible input values. So they're all of the values of x that have an actual output or a y value. When I do this from a graph, the easiest way or format to use is interval notation. So let's start out with this graph. So the smallest x value that this function is going to take on is going to be negative infinity. And then looking through, it looks like I have no issue. All of these x values have at least one y value that they go to. The only time we might have an issue is at negative 1. So at negative 1, this open circle means it's not defined there. However, it is defined at 4. So that x value of negative 1 does have a y value that it goes to. So I don't have an issue there. Keep on going. All of these x values have y values that they go to all the way down to positive infinity. So our domain is all real numbers, or from negative infinity to infinity. The range. So let's see. The smallest y value. So here's the y values. So the smallest y value this function takes on is going to be negative infinity, because that's going to go on for forever in that direction. The biggest y value, so it looks like all of these y values have at least one x value that goes to, at least one x value, at least one x value. At 3, we might have an issue because of this open circle, but luckily it has an x value it goes to.